Good morning students. We have started our microcontroller with the basics of microprocessor, microcontroller, what are all the different architectures we are using in microcontroller, what is the advantage of using microcontroller over microprocessor, what is meant by RISC architecture, CISC architecture, and then Von Neumann hardware architecture. And in the first module we have deal about the internal structure and internal organization of 8051 microcontroller and different types of addressing modes. Using those addressing modes we need to navigate our program. So in module 2 we are going to deal about the programming of 8051 using a mnemonics code. Before we write the program, first I wanted to show how exactly your microcontroller screen appears when you are using a KeyLU Vision 3. So the software what you are going to use for 8051 programming is KeyLU Vision 3. So this is the software you are going to use it. So using this software, I'll tell how to enter the screen. Okay. Now coming back to this, so when you go, you have to go to start, then you have to go to the program. So first in a computer you need to go to start. So in the start there will be program option. So inside the program option you will have a KeyLU Vision 3. So after clicking it, your screen appears like this. So here you will have a file that is menu bar where you can access everything, and it is the place, target place, that is whatever projects you are creating over here that will get appeared in this particular target one source group. So under source group you will get your file name. So this is the space where your file name will get appeared. So as soon as you click KeyLU Vision 3, the screen as shown over here will get appear. Next one, so after this I wanted to enter the new program. So before entering into the new program, first you need to create a project. So when you want to create a project, here you have an option called project. So in this there is a menu called new project, open project, close project. Suppose if a project has already been created, then you can go for open project. Suppose you are going to create a new project, then you need to click this new project. So before you create any new project, you need to close the other project. For example, if somebody, you are using one particular system, in the same system somebody might have opened some projects. So all those projects first you need to close it before you create a new project. This is your second step. Third step is going to be, after entering the project name, you are supposed to create a new project. So once you create, click the project name, here you will get a file name. So this file name, anything you can give. So usually the file extension of the project what you are creating is going to be UV2 or UV3. Why it is called as a UV2 or UV3 is, you are using KeyLU Vision 3 software. Therefore the file name created for the project will be .uv. Okay, this is your third step. And fourth step is going to be, you are going to use a Atmel microcontroller, 8051 microcontroller. So Atmel microcontroller, once the file name is given, your screen appears like this. So in this screen you could find a list of companies, that is Atmel, Ancro Chips, Analog Devices, Altium, Actel. All these are companies or manufacturers, not companies, all these are manufacturers who designed the chip. So here we are going to use 8051 microcontroller. So this 8051 microcontroller is developed by Atmel company. So you need to select Atmel in this particular screen. Once the Atmel is selected, then your screen will look like this. So after that you are selecting the Atmel, your screen looks like this. In this you need to select what is the microcontroller you are going to use. Now you are reading about 8051 microcontroller. So you need to select 8051, and in this you have to select AT89C51. AT is nothing but your Atmel. It is representing the Atmel chip. 89C51 is the microcontroller which you are going to use it for programming. After selecting this particular 89C51, your screen appears like this. So it will ask copy the standard 8051 startup code to project folder. So before this you will not get anything over here. That is, when you click over the target space, you will not get any source code. But after clicking the S button in this, here a source code will get developed as shown in your next screen. So you could see here you are going to have a source code. So once it is clicked, your screen appears like this, and here you are going to open the options for target. So options for target, why you are going to open? Because you need to set at what crystal frequency your controller is going to work. So if next, after this, after clicking the options for target, your screen appears like this. In this, you are supposed to select your crystal frequency as 11.0592. So this crystal frequency, it is constant for this 8051 microcontroller. So before you enter any program or before you make any interfacing program in 8051 microcontroller, before you run any program, your first thing is you need to change the frequency to 11.0592 megahertz. So already it is in megahertz, so in this place you need to type 11.0592 and you have to click OK. So once the click OK button is clicked, then you will be going on to the next screen as shown over here. So here you can find out your project name. Whatever name you have typed in the first one, that you can find out, and click here OK. So here you need to click your create hex file if you are going to have an interfacing program. After this, your screen looks like this. Now I wanted to enter a new program. So if I wanted to enter a new program, go to file menu. Under this file menu, you need to click new. So when you click new, your screen will appear as shown here. So this is you will get a screen as soon as from this file menu. If you click new, you will get such type of screen. So in this place, you can type your mnemonics program. That is, you can type the code whatever you are going to execute. This is how your Keyloo Vision 3 software works. So after typing the program, you consider you have already completed typing the program. Now you wanted to make this program to run, means you need to add this program to the source group. So in the target, so here you will have a plus sign. So when you click this plus sign, you will get one more subgroup called source group. So in this source group, if you make a right click, you will get add files to group source group 1. So after clicking over here, you can find your name of your file. So you can find your name of the file and you can add it in this particular screen. So after adding, you can see here, after typing every program and after the file has been added to the source group, okay, you need to build the target. So for that, go to project menu. There you give build target. So once you are given a build target, your file will look like this. So in microcontroller, the file name, the project file name extension is .uv. Suppose if you are using Keyloo Vision 3, means here .uv3 it will come. Suppose if you are using Keyloo Vision 2, means it will come .uv2. It depends upon the number of what version you are going to use, that number will appear here. And the project file name extension is going to be .uv because it is Keyloo Vision 3. And file name will be some name .asm. So ASM stands for assembly language program. In this, you can type the program in two ways. One is by using a mnemonics code, mnemonics. So mnemonics in the sense like MOV and ADD. So it will explain what type of instruction it is. Using mnemonics code, you can write the program, or using C, you can write the program. Suppose if you are using mnemonics code, the file extension, so after typing the program, you need to save the file with the extension .asm. Suppose if you are writing a C program and you are saving it, means you need to use .c. So .asm is a file extension that you need to save it for mnemonics code. .c is the file extension that you need to save the program for C. Okay. So after this, you can click start stop debug session and then you can run the program. So if you wanted to see whether the error is there or not, before for identifying the error, you need to go to project. So in the project, you have to type, you have to click build target. So when you are clicking this build target, you will get the number of errors and warnings at this particular place. After building the target, you need to go for start stop debug session where you can see your output. This is how you need to type, execute and run the program in case of 8051 microcontroller. So here in this, you could see three windows. Like, one is your memory window, that is register window, and this is your memory window. So in this only you will be typing the data, everything. And here in the address, you need to specify. Suppose you wanted to go for 40H. So in the address bar, you need to specify 0x40H. So here you need to type 0x40H so that your screen will appear like this. Suppose if you enter the memory location, I told it is a 40H. Even if you wanted to enter it for 30H, you need to type it as 0x30H. Before this, you need to type D colon. Right? So this is the basics of your KeyLew Vision software entering. Like, this is how it is, a step-by-step procedure how you wanted to enter your software. Thank you, students.